everyone. Today's model question is regarding the geographical importance of Himalayan ranges. So the question is like this: if there were no Himalayan ranges, what would have been the most likely geographical impact on India? Right? It's an ABCD kind of question. So if there were no Himalayan ranges, what difference would it have made? That's the question, right? So going to the first statement, the monsoon rains would have taken place in winter months. So they are saying like if Himalayan ranges were absent, like you know, the monsoon rainfall will be taking place in the winter months, right? That's the statement. So if you look at the monsoon period, right, the summer monsoon and the winter monsoon. So during the summer monsoon, the land is becoming more warmer and the low pressure system is being developed over the Indian subcontinent plus the Tibetan plateau regions. This low pressure attracts the winds and we are having the summer monsoon winds, right? And the Himalayan ranges block the monsoon winds, and so that the Indian subcontinent gets more rainfall during this summer monsoon wind. At the same time, the winter period, right, the land, the Tibetan plateau regions will be having more high pressure, right? At the same time, the Australian regions will be low pressure. So the wind will be moving from the Himalayan ranges, so from the northeast regions towards the southwest direction, right, blowing from continent, right, to the oceans. So the rainfall will be less during the winter monsoon and will be having high rainfall during the summer monsoon. This is the usual case, right? Imagine we are not having the Himalayan ranges. Even in that case, right, during the summer months, the low pressure will develop over these regions and the wind will get attracted and we'll be having rainfall taking place during the summer period, because the wind is coming from ocean moving towards the land. It will be carrying more moisture to the land. But if the other case, right, the wind is blowing from the Tibetan plateau towards the Indian subcontinent, it's blowing from a continental region having less moisture. So again, going back to the first statement, monsoon rains would have taken place in winter months, which is wrong. Even if the Himalayan ranges were absent, the monsoon would have still taken place during the summer months itself. And the second statement, coastal India would have experienced Mediterranean climate. The Mediterranean climatic regions, they are seen over the regions from 30 to 45 degree latitudes, right? These regions, they lie within the movement of wind belt. During the summer months, the wind belt will be moving upward, and during the winter months, the movement of the wind belt will be towards the south, right? So these regions, they are within this transition zone, right? The wind belt are migrating and these regions are within those latitudes, and those regions we call it as Mediterranean. I mean, those regions will be having Mediterranean climatic type, right? Mainly the winter rainfall, I mean the rainfall takes place during the winter months in the Mediterranean region, and they will be having dry conditions there during the summer months. That's the one specific feature of Mediterranean climatic type. Almost in all the other climatic regions, during the summer months we will be having high rainfall and during the winter months we will be having less rainfall. But in the Mediterranean regions, unlike all the other climatic types, their rainfall peaks during the winter. Okay, now since India is outside these regions, and since even though the Himalayan ranges are absent, right, we won't be having much difference being created in the case of, like, you know, the coastal India won't be experiencing the Mediterranean climate. So again, the statement B is wrong. So we have to, if we need to find out the statement as wrong, right, we have to think about the Mediterranean regions. The specific property of Mediterranean region is that the rainfall will be peaking during the winter period, right? So even if Himalayan ranges were absent, that won't be taking place. For that reason, the statement B is wrong. Now going through the statement C, North Indian plain would have been much cooler in winter. Okay. Now think about the period given in the statement is winter, right? So think about the winter period. The winds are blowing from the northeastern regions towards Indian subcontinent. Like, you know, or if you are specifically taking a region, you can say from Siberia or from Tibetan plateau towards the Indian subcontinent. Now, during the winter period, the land will be extremely cold, and during the summer period, the land will be very warm, right? Now, during the winter period, the Tibetan plateau and Siberian regions, they all will be extremely cold. So the winds blowing from those regions, they will be cold winds. Okay. Now in the normal case, since we are having the Himalayas will act as an obstacle for this dry cold wind blowing from the Tibetan and Siberian regions towards the Indian subcontinent. So if Himalayas regions were absent, more colder wind, I mean cooler wind, will be coming from the Himalayan ranges towards Indian subcontinent. So the third statement, right, the North Indian plain would have been much cooler in winter, which is true, because if Himalayan ranges were absent, the cooler winds without any obstacle will be reaching Indian subcontinent from the Siberian and Tibetan plateau regions, right? So the statement C is the correct answer. Again, going through the statement D, the northwestern part of India would have experienced humid conditions. Now the humid conditions in the northwestern part of India is not directly under the influence of Himalayan ranges, right? These regions, they get very scanty rainfall from the Indian monsoon, right? So the Himalayas, they are not predominantly influencing the rainfall over these regions, and for this reason, even if the Himalayan ranges were absent, right, it won't be influencing the northwestern regions, like it won't be making the northwestern regions more humid. For that reason, the statement D is again wrong. So here the answer comes out as C. If Himalayan ranges were absent, the North Indian plain would have been much cooler in winter.